What's up, guys? It's your boy Rico here with ZimKyo News, back at you again with another video. Now, guys, obviously, you know how much I've been hyping everything up with the AJ Tyson Fury fight. It's actually, like, it's pissing me off now, like, proper, because obviously with Eddie, he's saying everything is done, because obviously Eddie's the one with the deal and who's doing everything with the Saudis, but this is what you hear from this guy the next minute.
Until we agree to terms, until Tyson Fury, which is who we're with, until he's happy with the terms, it won't get signed, and he's not happy at the moment. I don't know what Anthony Joshua's position is, because we've had nothing to do with that.
Give us an insight then. In the...
What do you mean, the terms, bro? What are you talking about? What do you mean, the terms? What? There's 150 million there. Tyson gets half. Everything gets cut down the middle. I don't actually understand what you mean. Are you okay? This is the conversation, Frank, bro. This is the conversation, right? How are you going to say to Prince Abdul Aziz or whatever like that there? Because Frank is basically saying, like, okay, look. So it all stems from the fact that Frank is basically saying that they need confirmation from the bank to know that the money's there. What do you mean confirmation from the bank? The Saudis are the bank, bro. Okay, the Saudis are the bank. How did that conversation even start? Yeah, Prince, basically, you know, we kind of need confirmation from the bank. I am the bank, bro. He could literally sign something on a napkin and that shit is actually real. Okay? This is actually ridiculous now. Because I'm trying to hold back all of the naysayers and negative people, mainly the Wilder fans, you know, the nerds over there, basically saying this fight isn't going to happen. But come on, guys, man, you lot fucking owe it to us. You owe it to us to give us this fight and deliver this fight. The fighters do as well. We support you. We buy your fights every single time. Well, I know I do. But then in time and time again, you have to just put a downer on everything. And it's not just with this fight. Look at the Terrence and Crawford and Spence fight. It's ridiculous. Why do we always have to be holding our breath for something? Why can't it just be this guy is going to fight this guy. One, done deal. Yeah? Because I understand to a certain extent the exclusivity of a fighter on one network. But the thing is, unless all the networks are prepared to just form one whole combination, you're never gonna get people fighting on cross promotions. You're not gonna get other fighters fighting other fighters, you know, and that hinders the sport. And then that's why you get YouTubers like Jake Paul and Logan and everybody else that want to just punch each other up, and people are paying money for the fights because it's like, wow, well, at least it's interesting, you know. Come on, man. Come on, Frank, bro. Just deliver for us. For once, just deliver for us. We're asking you, please. Yeah? Because I want this fight next. I don't want any other fight. I will not be paying for any other fight for either of those two if it's not next. Because who else are they going to fight? Yeah, AJ can fight his mandatory. Fury can fight somebody else. But what? Why? Why would you? There's 150 million reasons why you should be booking that plane to Saudi, you know? Listen, I've almost had enough of this, to be honest with you, but at the end of the day, we're at the mercy of these people right now, so we just have to cross our fingers and just hope that this fight is going to be next. Anyway, guys, please like and subscribe, comment what you think. I don't know what's happening here, but I'm hoping for the best. Like always, God bless.